Welcome back to another lesson of getting started on Expivi. In the previous lesson, we saw how we can import a 3D model and set up a basic configuration for different variations on a product. In this lesson, I'm going to take you over an overview of the showcase, where you can set up the different lightings and how you want to present the product on your website to the customers. So this part is actually about the presentation and the visualization of the materials, the lighting, and how the product is generally presented to the customers. So after importing and configuring our 3D model, we go to the showcase, which is the next step. And inside here, where you come in, there's a possibility that you wouldn't directly see the product inside here, as I have over here. And this is actually because the 3D model that I had imported wasn't drawn in meters. So it's actually too big for my scene. So if you encounter that kind of problem where you have your model tree inside your configuration and you see that your 3D model is just inside there, but it's not visible inside the showcase, there is a big chance that it is being placed inside the showcase, but it's just too small or too big to be presented on the view. So the way you navigate inside the showcase is with the right mouse button, you can pan or drag and move the scene around. With the scroll button, you can zoom in and zoom out. And with the left mouse button, you can rotate around the product. And if, like me, your product is too small or too big, when you have come into the showcase, we have a few different parts where we can insert. We have the scene hierarchy, when a scene present representation of the things that we have added to the scene. We have the properties panel and we have the toolbar panel. So when first time I come to the showcase, the scene hierarchy will be closed. I can open it by selecting the scene hierarchy. And if I don't see my product, I can select the configurable node. So this is actually the 3D model that we had imported during the previous step. And you can select that one. And you can change the scaling of that model. So I'm going to make it the smaller and see how big then it becomes. So the size and scaling doesn't matter that much as long as you are able to see the product and you can set up your lightings the way you want. So I'm going to make this a little smaller so I have a little more space in the scene to move around. So I'm going to scale it down and it's been scaled down. I'm going to change the one material that has been transparent for some reason. And in here, I have now actually the basic setup of my scene. Before this product can be presented inside the preview on or on your web shop, we need to set up a few things. One is the lighting and the other is the camera. So the lighting is actually where the light is shining on the object and the camera is where the product is being viewed from. And we can do that by going into the insert. In CRT here, we have a few different options that we can add to our product. For this particular product, we want to add a light and we have a different few different options to select from. So the directional light is a light with just a direction. Ambient is a generic light that will reflect light generally on every angle on the product. So it doesn't have any position or direction. It's just basic how much ambient there is. So it's a generic light intensity on everything. Then we have the hemispheric light, which is also automatically placed inside the scene when you open your product. And the hemispheric light has an interesting property, and that is that it has a light object and a hemispheric light object, which is the ground color and the color. And the difference between those two is that you have two different colors that are being shining on the object. The one is from the side, that is in front of the object, and the other one is the ground color, which is in the back side. So the front side is the color that object gets on the outer side, which is to the point of facing the light point, and the ground color is the light that is lit on the object on the other side or on the opposite side of the light point. And this gives you a little freedom of playing around with the light, where you want to have a little more general lighter surfaces on the front or back side when there is not enough lighting by the other light types that you have added to the scene. So I'm going to add a directional light inside here by going insert and add the directional. It will appear directly inside my scene hierarchy. Then I can go on and select the light and move it around. One thing to keep in mind about the light is that lights that have a direction, you cannot rotate around those lights. You can just move them around. And if you want to change the point where they are pointing at, or where the light direction is pointing at, you need to go to select the light item, go to its properties, and underneath you have toggle target. And what it does is actually it will toggle the repositioning of the object or the target that it's pointing at. So I can say I want it to be pointing or reflecting to that target or reflecting to which direction. So the target is actually where the light is reflecting at. So with my directional light, I have set it up to be reflecting from this position a little more up, so that I can see light is shining from that direction, which is the direction of the my directional light, which I just added. And then I'm going to decrease the hemispheric light, which just is the general light that is been shining on everything. So if I remove or put this as zero, the incense, so you can see that at the moment there is only the directional light that has been shining just from one direction. So you can see everything from that direction is lit and everything at the other direction is completely black. And that's because no light is coming to it from any direction. And our hemispheric light actually will lit the object from both sides. So it will lit from the side that is pointing at and also lit it from the side that is on the opposite side. I'm going to decrease it to have a little bit. Usually you want to have the color of the light that is directing at, or the front inside, you want to have that one a little bit lower, because we already have a light shining from the directional from this side. So I want to lit actually the back side a little more. I don't want to lit the front side anymore, because otherwise it will be overlit from one side, which also has a directional light shining from that direction on it. So with that, I have added lighting to this object. I can see that it's properly lit. And next I'm going to add a camera. So again, from insert camera, I can select the camera. It will be directly added to the scene graph. And I can also actually select for every object that has been added to the scene. I can also just left mouse click on it and it will select it directly. And the camera is being placed when we view the product from preview or on the web shop that we have. The product will be viewed from the camera that is being set to the scene. And in order to select and place the camera to the point that I want it to be pointing at or be viewing from, I can either just move the camera around, move its direction. Also, the camera has a target transform. So again, toggling on the target. So this is the focus where the camera is actually looking at. So we have, I want it to be looking at exactly the center of the object. And then I can also set the position of the camera in the other way as well. So I can just move around my view, put the object in a certain view that I want to be viewing the object from, and then just set the camera. So when I select the set camera button, I confirm, it will place the camera at the position I was looking at the object. Still, in here, if I hadn't transformed the focus of the camera, if it had been on the zero point, if I go back and select the view camera, so it would actually show me the view position, I see that the object is a little higher and it's not properly centered. That is because the focus of the camera is still at the center. So in order to change that, when the camera is selected, I need to go to the properties, to the focus point, and change the focus to the place where I want the camera to be focused at. So I place it at the center of the object, and now the camera will be viewing at the center exactly of that object. So when I go back and view the object, I see that it centers on the point that I have set the focus of the camera. Another thing on the camera is how you want the camera to view the product. So we have orbit and we have first person. Orbit means that the camera wheel will rotate around its focus point. So to give you an overview of that, when I'm done in here, don't forget to save all of the changes if you are going to navigate to other tabs. Otherwise, you will lose all of the work that you have done inside the scene. So I've saved it. And if I go to preview, I see that my lighting is being set up and my camera. And going back to what I was talking about, the camera controller is the orbit and the first person. So since I have set my focus point of my camera to the center of this object, and I have selected controller of the camera as orbit, I can orbit around the object. Now, if I go back and reselect the camera and change its controller to first person and resave it, go back to a preview, I will see now that I have a first person view that is like a person looking at the object and looking up and down. So you have two different options for the camera as a controller, how you want the customer to view the product when they navigate around the product inside the visualization area. I have added my camera. I have added my lights. Next thing I can do is change the background of the view. And in order to do that, I need to select the layer that I'm currently working on. So the default layer that has been generated during the first time for me, I can just select that layer, go to the view background options, and from here I can select from different options. So transparent is actually when you want to have the background of the 3D model or of your visualization to be transparent, so you can actually see through it on your website. Next, we have the color, where you can select different colors as our background for our product. And we can select any type of color that we want for it. There is also the possibility to select an image. So when I select an image, it will place an image on background. So I can go on, assign an image from it. It will look on my media library, find all of the images that are available, and I can just select an image inside there and put it as my background. So for example, if I select that one, it will place that one as my background, and if I find some other image that I have, for example, just a street, select it, and it will preview that image as background. Another option that you have is the cube map, which is a skybox. So inside here, you can have six-sided images to represent your product as if it was inside the environment. I'm going to choose a color, set this as one color that I want for background of product, save it again. And then again, when I go to the preview, it will view the product from the first person camera view. Or if I go back and change the camera to use orbit as controller, save it and go back to preview, I can rotate around it. It has the correct background color, lighting on it, and also I can change between the different variations that I had for the product that I had set up previously on my configuration. So there is one more thing that we are going to look into, and that is the materials of the object. In order to change the different options of my product, I can select the product node. That's the root node that you have inside the scene hierarchy. I can go to the attributes and change between the different variations that I have as my attributes. And when I have selected each one of the variations I want, I can also select on the object itself, and it will load up the material properties of the part that I have selected. Inside here, I can then again change the different colors that I want to have and directly get a visual feedback of how the product is going to look like. You have a variety of different options that you can select from, and there is also a variety of different types that you can select, that you can set up as material type, like physical base shading, standard shading, and some other types that we have, but we will go through that in some later lessons. Again, if I change something inside the material, I need to save changes for the material, because otherwise if I select away from it, it will reset the material properties that I have changed. So when I select an object, a part of it, I can change some color, save it, and when I select away from it, it will remain there. So the inner shell, I'm going to change that as well. It has some property on it. And with that, actually, I have set up all of the basics that are required to set up the visual presentation of a product. The only thing I need are a few good lights, a little bit of changes on the materials, and a camera. And you have set that up. You are ready to go to preview the product and actually see the product inside Expivi's platform. I can preview the product from here, or I can go to my account, which is your team account, .expivi.nem. I can select the product. I can actually directly see the product on the platform and select from all of the different variations that I have set up for my product. If you're using either e-commerce platform like Magento, Shopify, WooCommerce, or other websites or shopping platforms, you can use one of our plugins to preview the product inside those platforms as well. Or you can download our augmented reality app to view the product also directly inside augmented reality. In the next lessons, we are going to show you how you can set up different materials and this different set of material selections on the product to make it even more realistic, and also to give the options for the customer to select between different materials. Thank you very much. Until next time. Bye-bye.